Hello again, Bea here, and welcome back to Biology. Good news, we are ready to start a brand new unit. Now that you know all about cells and the processes that go on inside them, we'll be taking a closer look at some of the specific molecules inside cells. Do you see what's going on behind me? Any guess what molecule we might be focusing on in this unit? Back in Unit 1, we briefly introduced the concept of genetics. You may remember that we talked about DNA and chromosomes, and said that this was the genetic material that gets passed down from our parents and tells our cells what to do. Specifically, DNA tells our cells how to make protein. This is important because protein is necessary for every single job that our cells have to carry out, and it builds the foundation of our bodies. The science of how traits are passed on is called genetics. And because we'll be looking at the foundations of genetics at a molecular level, our unit is called molecular genetics. We'll study the molecular structure of DNA and see how it allows for the building of protein molecules. As we go through this lesson, we'll look at some of the big ideas we'll see in this unit, and you'll have a chance to download or print out the unit PDF. You surely have heard of DNA. Do you know what it stands for? Deoxyribonucleic acid. So, we'll usually just go with DNA. DNA has a double helix shape that resembles a twisted ladder. At certain times, DNA coils itself tightly around itself into structures called chromosomes. That's why sometimes we'll use the terms DNA and chromosomes interchangeably. Hopefully you remember from your unit on cells that DNA is found in the nucleus of the cell. Except, of course, in prokaryotic cells, because they don't have a nucleus. In their case, the DNA tends to congregate in a region of the cell called the nucleoid, but it isn't protected by a nuclear membrane like it is in a eukaryotic cell. Regardless of where it's located, all cells have DNA, because all cells have to make protein. The process of making protein is very complicated and involves many steps. We'll look at the basic steps in this unit, including how DNA is first transcribed into a strand of mRNA, and then the mRNA is translated into an amino acid chain. The amino acid chain will then undergo a complex folding procedure to be turned into a fully functional protein. The instructions for how to complete these steps are found in the DNA. We know that DNA is responsible for passing instructions from parents to offspring, but how exactly does that work? Our bodies and the bodies of most living things undergo the process of meiosis, which creates special cells for reproduction. These cells only have half of the organism's DNA because the other half of the DNA for the offspring will need to come from the other parent. When DNA is passed on to offspring, or simply copied to make new cells during mitosis, it is always possible that mistakes will be made. These mistakes can lead to mutations. During this unit, we'll look at some of the ways DNA can mutate. I guess it's possible that a mutation could lead to a weird mutant frog like this, but probably not likely. We'll wrap up this unit by looking at a crime scene investigation and exploring the ways that technology can make use of DNA to identify individuals and improve human health. As you go through the unit, don't forget to complete the activities in the PDFs after each video. These pages have additional information about the topic of the lesson, as well as activities and experiments to complete. You will need the information from these activities to successfully complete the assessments for each lesson. The PDF that you will find attached to this lesson has all of the PDF materials for the whole unit. Don't worry, there's nothing you need to complete in the PDF for this video. Just download the PDF or print it out so that you have it ready for the rest of the unit. If you do forget or your pages get lost, you can also find the PDF for each individual lesson after the lesson video. I can't wait to start telling you all about DNA and how it builds the protein our bodies need. Until then, remember that biology isn't just science, it's the way of life. Hey, hey.